Your judges score this bout 29-28, 29-28, and 30-27 in favor of your winner by way of unanimous decision. In the red corner, the Boxing Gladiator, Modestas Bukauskas.
My fight with Lee, it was good. We got the win, but it was by no means the best performance that I could have possibly put out there. I know a lot of people are saying, oh yeah, you've had 14 months out the cage, you know, you got the win, that was the main thing. But you can already see in their faces that they're like, oh yeah, it was good, but it was... No one's really talking about it, you know? Not that I really care, you know, that people are talking about, but you need that. You need the traction, you need the attention, you need people to be grasped or by what it is that you're doing out there in the cage. So for me to have a win where it was good, I got the job done, you know, I got my foot back in the door, I started trying to do different things, and it kind of was running along the same theme of the things that I was not doing in my UFC fights, which was letting loose fully. Could have been a hell of a lot of improvement, which is why there wasn't much traction or wasn't much big talk about it, which is why I want to go out and absolutely kick off this new year with a bang in my next fight, because not only do the fans deserve it, not only does I deserve it, but for everyone that's been supporting me, I need to put on the performance that I'm capable of. People know what I can do, and I've not yet shown it, so I'm ready to do that.
Both my legs are on the ground, and I'm here. You need to get out of this position. You need to get into a better position before starting doing anything. Nothing here is going to work.
2 minutes spar upstairs, and then 1 minute afterwards, you have 30 seconds to do something in parterre, and then 30 seconds the other part. So you switch top to bottom. I want to see five pairs on the mat now, everybody else off.
Face from all the stress. Good round to that. Soon there will be chauffeurs and limos, but for now we take the train. So you know I'm a narcissist, always wondering about my hair. In a good way though. if there's ever a good way. I'll be known as the comeback king by the end of all of this, mate. I'm telling you. The freaking comeback king.
You have got to fucking ruin this cunt.
Proper, mate. The plan is simple. Take him out by any means possible. And this is a championship 5 rounds as well.
Is it? Oh, yeah.
We ain't using 5 rounds, though.
We could bash him up for 4 rounds and then fuck him up.
Nah, I want to take him out early, mate. Yeah, so after that, mate, we'll... 100% I'm fucking coming around your place. I'm gonna stop being like a shit friend, and I don't really
want to see you, so don't fucking worry, man. I ain't gonna be so shit.
This will be the first time that I will be a main event in a Cage Warriors card. It's quite a big thing. You know, because Conor McGregor was the main event on New Year's Eve when he won the double, when he became double champ, and then obviously moved on to the UFC. So this is quite a big moment for me, you know, to become a two-time champion.
Attack the legs. It's a fast way to get a submission, especially if you're behind. Let's grab the gum shield. Let's just roll.
Thanks, man. So the top of that list, in terms of priority, is to get the finish. So through the leg kicks, through the takedowns, through the hard shots getting in range. What needs to be done in this fight is to get the finish.
look good now, as we have a supposed to go. This time, really gladiators, you're going to kill person. Because if you don't kill him, he kills you. It's just it. This is mentality. But doesn't mean you need to change. No emotions, calm and do what you do, with techniques. But no way. You go to this, go in, step to the side, what we did. Or shoot and take down. That's it.
The training session felt a bit hanging today. This whole week I've been feeling hanging, but it's what you gotta do to become a champion, right? But I feel in shape. Skinny face. Strong hair. Dad always helping me out. Go and bring back the massive win. This is our fight. UFC straight after. This is the journey, this is the comeback. This is where the story actually means something. It didn't even really mean anything before, but now it does. Now it does. This is where we're going to be. I rep it all the time. Speak it into existence, right? Yes, mate. Man's looking fresh after that fresh fade. Boy, I'm feeling fresh.
Said you've got another fight booked?
Yeah, so I'll be fighting for the light heavyweight title again on New Year's Eve on the Team Europe v Team USA card versus Chuck Campbell. It's a very big moment for me because I will be the first and only guy to have vacated the belt and then won it back again.
There's so much hard work, so much hardship that I had to go through to get to this point. I've been visualizing this moment every single day and how it's come to life.
I had an opponent turn me down a couple of times that this guy fought.
Yeah. All two headshots!
That's now one American guy.
And it's over!
He asked for the belt. I said, look, I just beat Lee Chadwick, amazing fighter, a unanimous decision victory, so a clear win in a comeback fight where he's ranked 80 in the world. I'm ranked 55 in the world, so a top ranked worldwide guy. I said, you know, I'll call for the belt. So now I get to fight for the belt again. I'll get the belt again. And then guess what? Sky's the limit. UFC is definitely going to be knocking on the door after that. We are in the Golf, the Volkswagen Golf. Had to take a little cheeky exchange of cars. It wasn't due to my bad driving. People say, I ain't got grappling or I ain't got wrestling. It's just because no one's really seen it before, you know? I can grapple with the best of them. Yeah, I'm not the best grappler. I'm not gonna beat the top level guys, but I will give anyone a freaking hard time. And in MMA, it's completely different when there's strikes involved.
My takedown defense has definitely held up every single fight. It'll only continue to get better, and then I'm gonna start taking people down, and then it's gonna get real, real scary for them. So, yeah, vibes!
I think if there's anything to learn about this whole situation as a whole is that anyone can come back from adversity. I'm not special by any means. I've failed many times in my life. I wanted to be a tennis player. I wanted to be a basketball player. Those things didn't happen, you know. I wanted to be a champion in the UFC within the first year. That didn't even happen. I got cut from the UFC and I'm still coming back. I just won my first fight back in Cage Warriors where no one thought I was ever going to come back. Literally, I had people message me 2 weeks before that fight happened telling me this guy is never going to come back. He's finished. His career's over. And then I go and win a fight. And it's just like, so where's all these comments now? And I know that everything, all this hard work, all this effort, all this dedication, all this commitment, all this heartbreak will mean something in the end. And I think there'll be a true statement of me being the comeback king once this is all said and done.
Right, so we're just going to change this up a little bit. Still 13-5, but KO, bruv. 13-5 with 11 finishes.